Of course, when we talk about a breakdown and failure, you need to have definitions of what the different things are called. So what we call a failure, maybe a little bit different than yours, we call it failure is when the equipment condition reaches an unacceptable level. Too high of a temperature, too high of vibration, too small of a flow, whatever it may be. It reaches an unacceptable level. It's still operating or could be operating. That failure will then develop into a breakdown. Breakdown is when it stops functioning. So it's a time period from when you have a failure to a breakdown. And what you want to do in your inspections, of course, do an inspection somewhere here so I can find the failure. And once I find the failure, I can plan and schedule to do the corrective action before I have a breakdown. So that time period is, of course, for managing maintenance, extremely important. We're going to get into how do we set our inspection frequencies and how do you base that on and what you do daily, weekly, hourly, and how do you decide that. When we talk about root cause in the end of tomorrow, we're going to talk about root cause a bit. That's really talking about the source. What initiated that whole curve? What was it that started? What are the things that started this to actually happen? That's really finding the source or finding the root cause. So those are the definitions that we use. So failure is still operating. So in this case here, this is a hot motor. It's full of lime. It's running really hot. A few weeks later, that developed. It had gotten so hot that the shaft actually snapped, and there's also overload and some other things to it. So it's usually not one thing that leads to a failure. You'll see that when we do root cause. I've never done a root cause when we come up with, oh, this was the one thing that did, you made it fail. So usually three or four things.